343 has stated that Halo Infinite will be the Halo platform for the next 10 years. Is this going to be good for the franchise or will it be detrimental? We'll stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another news and informational video when it comes to Halo. If you like these news, informational videos, please make sure to tap that like button as it lets me know you want to see some more content like this, and it greatly helps out the video get some more recognition so more people get to stay in the know with everything happening with Halo. So recently, some 343 devs, like Chris Lee, who's the head of Halo Infinite, and a few other developers went into like a call with a few other notable members within the gaming news community to kind of do a developer commentary over what they were watching and do a Q&A afterwards. As stated by the developers, it's the start of our platform for the future. Basically, this is going to be the last standalone release that for the foreseeable future when it comes to Halo, which is quite a drastic change from what we've seen from the entire franchise as a whole. So basically, Halo Infinite's like, forget everything you know about how we receive Halo Infinite as media in general. Continuing on, Chris Lee does say that we want Infinite to grow over time versus going into these numbered titles and having all that segmentation that we had before. It's really about catering Halo Infinite as the start of a next 10 years of Halo and then building that as we go with our fans and community. So will we see a Halo 7? Will we see Infinite 2? No, we're not gonna see that, because we're going to treat this game as a platform. Now, we do know that this is something that they've stated previously, that they want Halo Infinite to be a game as a service or as a platform kind of thing. They do mention how Halo Infinite's not going to be a live service game, say like Destiny, but it's going to be like a solid place where if you want to play Halo, you go to Halo Infinite. Stated here in the IGN article says, this does not mean that Halo Infinite is a live service game a la Destiny, but it does mean that new story experiences will be told underneath Infinite's umbrella, and it also means Infinite will be evolved technologically for quite a while. Obviously, if you're looking to have this be your game as a platform for the next 10 years, graphical increases are going to happen over 10 years, so you can't be playing a 10-year-old game and call it new gen or current gen, obviously. So this is what the Slipspace Engine offers for 343, is that they're able to continually improve like the visuals, which has been a big issue with since the gameplay reveal, and improve the gameplay mechanics as well. And I think that's an awesome idea for the franchise as a whole. The reason why I feel very positive about Halo Infinite moving to a game as a platform, because what is Halo? That's a question that has changed quite a lot over the years, especially the last 10 years after the original trilogy was completed. I think the issue that's happened with Halo is that we basically perfected the wheel when it comes to Halo gameplay. I still feel strong that Halo 3 had the best and strongest gameplay that the franchise has ever had. So then when 2010 rolled around, we had to release another game. And what do you have to do to make this game new and exciting to make it more than just DLC content, which people would criticize at the time? But you also have to make it Halo, but make it new and bring in some new features and gameplay mechanics to justify its existence. And so things end up getting changed because they need to justify a new game. That's why you saw, like with Halo Reach from Halo 3, the fact that you had the DMR change as the primary weapon from the battle rifle. You saw all these different abilities and armor abilities being added into the game to justify some new gameplay mechanics, so then you can justify why you need to buy this game. At the time, if Bungie just, you know, kept this exact same formula and just brought some new maps, maybe some new weapons and a campaign, people would just complain that it'd be DLC and they'd just probably rather play Halo 3. So you need to make enough changes to make it so it's not the same game as the last one, but also have it feel similar to where it still feels like Halo. You can kind of see where we're getting at here, that there's only so much you can perfect and change to a certain point. And I think that's what they're trying to accomplish with Halo Infinite, as they want to create a solid game. They want to have the foundations of what Halo Infinite is to be what the vision of Halo is moving forward, so they can focus more on creating content like campaign missions, extra weapons, whatever they can do with the Slipspace Engine, and so rather than try to focus so much on trying to change everything, because every time a new Halo game comes out, there's some drastic change that affects the gameplay directly. Creating this divide where you have classic fans, you have modern fans, you have fans of Halo Reach, you have fans of Halo 4, but maybe not Halo 3, and they have these different groups of subgroups of fans that who liked their own versions of each game of Halo, because Halo has changed so much, especially in the past 10 years, that we just need to have a straight vision of what the game needs to be, so then we can move forward and focus on making what is there really good, rather than trying to have to constantly try to justify a new version of it. With the new Slipspace engine, they've put a big emphasis on allowing developers to update the game and create content at a speed we've never seen before with the Halo franchise. So this is why I'm really excited about Halo Infinite, that if there's anything that's wrong with the game, something the community doesn't like, or something that could be improved, it can be done. Unlike Halo 5, where they basically try to fit a square into a circle, basically, where they tried to make it into like a live service game, but it had old infrastructure of like your traditional numbered release games. And so that's why we only saw support for maybe like a year and a half. And I guarantee you, about that year and a half of content that we got for Halo 5 was just cut content from the game's release. As we do know, that was the big complaint about Halo 5, that it was an incomplete game. In fact, within this section with the Q&A that they had afterwards, they were asked, is Halo Infinite gonna be released with everything in the game? And it sounds like they didn't want to just like straight up say, yes, it's gonna have this on launch. So it's because they, right now, with how the pandemic's going around and how uncertain a lot of development can be right now, what they can really confirm with the game, that I understand why they don't want to say specifically what things are gonna come. Like, we do know the Forge is coming in, we do know that there's split screen, and we do know that there's multiplayer, there's a campaign, open world, all that great stuff. Essentially, what I'm getting at is that nothing is absolute with Halo Infinite, as some of the leaks do suggest when it comes to the Slipspace engine and how much it helps the development of this game. In fact, they're even going to patch in RTX, which is going to greatly improve the lighting within this game. Though that RTX patch is going to happen post-launch as well, so keep that in mind. Though it just kind of goes to show you that they can even patch in the visuals of the game. Like, nothing is finalized. Nothing, everything's subject to change. Everything is, can be changed by the community feedback to where we can have the Halo game that we want and feel proud to play. So essentially what I'm getting at here is that Halo Infinite is built for the long term. There's a lot of things that can go differently with Halo Infinite. It's not like how it's been with previous Halo games, where what was released, it's kind of hard to change. With Infinite, there's a lot that can be changed. Okay, so yes, we do have our concerns, and you rightfully do have your concerns, especially with the visual presentation, as there was quite a lot of things there. The detail was just not there that we've normally had with Halo, but this is a completely different type of Halo game. And I have faith that in the long run, that this game is gonna be one of the best Halo games that's ever been created. I can believe that. And what it takes is constructive community feedback along with prompt action by 343 to give us the game that we want, and hopefully it will be a successful title for the Xbox Series X and for Halo just in general. So thank you very much for watching. I greatly appreciate it, guys. I know it's a little bit ranty on here, but I think this context is very much needed for a 10-year plan when it comes to Halo. As we've heard this before with Destiny, but obviously things are subject to change, and things might be subject to change as well for Halo Infinite. As long as it, you know, sells and holds up a player base, we'll see what happens, you know? Leave a comment down below what your guys' thoughts are on this game becoming a service platform when it comes to Halo. It's the first time we've ever had it happen. And so I'd like to see what the community's thoughts are on this as well. If you're new to the channel, make sure to check subscribe to keep yourself up to date with all the content coming on the channel. If you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo Infinite, check out the videos on the screen right over here. Over here, I got a link to all my recent news and informational videos. If you've been out of the loop for the last few days or so, and there's been a lot of news and info for the last couple of days. Thank you for watching. I greatly appreciate it, and I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.